for me this event is really special because I think we managed to gather like top researchers on our field.
Most of the time after somebody's talk, you corner them and you either learn things or hopefully they learn something from you.
I remember when we start planning this, we make like a wish list of the researchers that we would like to have here speaking about their research, and I'm happy to see that most of them agreed to come.
If I get invited to a conference which looks interesting and I'll learn something, if it's possible, I'll go.
The same reason that most people attend all scientific meetings, and that is to exchange information.
Our aim is to predict these orthology and paralogy relationships between proteins of fully sequenced genomes, and the number of fully sequenced genomes is increasing by the day. So we also want to use a technique which is based on phylogeny reconstruction, which is in itself is computationally intensive. We had several challenges to do this, and one of the bypasses we found is to not only use the resources that we were computing, but also gathering phylogenetic information that was deposited in other databases elsewhere, in other centers, and then to combine all these computations to produce a consensus prediction.
We now have the complete human genome and the Neanderthal genome. So that allows us to reconstruct some aspects of human history that you have no other way to reconstruct. But the main interest and the main power, I think, of what we call genomics, DNA sequencing these days, is the medical applications. We've discovered that a single gene error doesn't produce most diseases. Most diseases are produced by multiple errors, or at least single errors in many different genes. And by mega-analysis, we're just beginning to get a handle on that.
When you use these machines to generate data for several purposes, you have to be a little bit careful that this bias won't, it's not like it ruins your results, it just has the capacity to distort them a little bit. So it's, I would say it's not a major problem, but it's an issue that people want to deal with. It's all about data from these new machines. So that's the kind of challenge to me, how to fix it up.
We have gathered really a great bunch of speakers from all around the world. So for me, it's like an amazing opportunity to listen to these people.